Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله الرحمة المهداة والنعمة المزدانة على أعوذ بالله من شرور الأنفس من سيئات الأعمال من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أما بعد. Just like to do a little bit revision for number 3, then we'll go to number 4. He said that, you remember this is Hatim al Asam speaking to Shakik al Balki. He tells him that he learned 8 things. After he asked him, what did you learn after 30 years being in my company? What did you learn from me? Then he started listing the 8 things that he learned from him. And we finished number 3, we go to number 4. But I would like that, actually we did finish number 4 as well, but let me review them very quickly. قال إني رأيت كل واحد من الناس يسعى في جمع حطام الدنيا ثم يمسكها قابضا يده عليه فتأملت في قوله تعالى ما عندكم ينفد وما عند الله باق فبذلت محصولي من الدنيا لوجه الله تعالى ففرقته بين المساكين ليكون ذخرا لي عند الله تعالى. Said, I saw that every human being, or most people, they really compete on gathering materialistic gains. And hutam means the thing that is not lasting, the thing that will perish, will vanish. ثم يمسكها قابضا يده عليه. That a person will collect the dunya, the material world, then we hold into it, and he will not, he or she will not share it. They will hold very closely to it, thinking that it will last forever. Then I reflected in the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ما عندكم ينفد, whatever you have will perish. How much money a person can have, and it's still, you know, as more you spend it, you spend from it, it become less. But also that the person can be vanished himself, although the wealth left the wealth behind. So Allah says, "Ma indakum yanfad," whatever you may have, will run out. Even your children, grandchildren, anyone who use that money, it's still money will not last itself, will not last forever. Ma yanfad. Wa ma inda Allahi baq, and whatever is with Allah is everlasting. That therefore he says, when I come to know that, I believe what Allah says, I spend my gain of dunya, mahsuli min al-dunya, وفرقته على المساكين. I divided this, I distributed, I gave it away to the people who are needy. ليكون ذخرا لي عند الله تعالى. So that it will become the real gain for me before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذخر in Arabic. يقول ذخر means a saving. Okay? ذخرك من الدنيا, what you have gain. The real gain is the akhirah gain. The dunya gain are conditioned for akhirah gain. If they are not, then they are lost. You know what I mean? Therefore, your gain, for example, you promoted in your job, that's a gain. You get more money, that's a gain. It is a real gain if you use that extra money, the extra prestige, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being single, then being married. You have gained a wife or a husband. That marriage, that relationship should bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That become real gain. You know, anything a person does in life, have to calculate it. Is it gain, a real gain, or a gain that is lost? Is a lost. You know what I mean? Sometimes you gain, but you lose. People who win the lottery, do they gain or no? Yeah. Material wise, though. Material wise, do they gain?
Yes.
Material wise, don't say no. Material wise, they gain. But they gain, but they lose at the same time. Let me tell you something. I want you to Google this. This is true. This is young ladies and young men. There's most of the people have won big time lottery. They're unhappy people. Some of them have committed suicide. Some of them got deep depression. Only one person out of 20 was happy person. You know why? He gave it away. He gave all of it. He said, I want to be like I used to be. But every person have won this super something, lived miserable life. Every one of them regretted, do the research. Every one of them regretted that they won the lottery. Subhanallah. They said their life before it, they were better. Allah speaks the truth. إِنَّمَا يُرِدُ الشَّيْطَانِ يُوقَعَ بَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ فِي الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ وَصُدَّكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَعَنِ الصَّلَاةِ فَالْأَنْتُمْ مُنْتَهُونَ Satan would like to bring animosity and hate between you and alcohol and gambling and take you away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, each one of those people have gained or won the lottery big time, they live a miserable life. Each one of them said, I wish I have not bought that ticket. Would you believe that? It's amazing. This is not my research. The research is tonight. And you'll come to know what I'm telling is true. I'm telling out of facts. Interview. Everyone was interviewed. Some of them commit suicide. Some of them went to deep depression. Some of them, they said, I wish I had that ticket. I did not buy it. Subhanallah. Therefore, here, Imam Hatim, I'm talking about the gain with Allah. If you gain with Allah, you really have gain. Because it's Allah the one who gave the dunya to begin with. And the use of material in pleasing Allah, that's what Allah wants of us. Not displeasing Him. Al-Fa'idah al-Rabi'ah. قال إني رأيت بعض الخلق. I was just reviewing, by the way, for those who come late. I did not go to the new material. I just reviewing it because I know the rain have kept some people of coming on time. And I was on time. You know, at 7 o'clock, the people saw that we were coming late.
Alhamdulillah.
Al-Fa'id al-Rabi'ah. Inni ra'aytu ba'd al-khalq. Dhanna sharafu wa izzuhu fi kathrat al-aqwam wal-ashar. Some people, they think that the honor and dignity and prestige in how much money you have, how many children you have, how much al-aqwam wal-ashar. فاغطر بهم, become arrogant because of them. وزعم آخرون أنه في ثروة الأموال. Some people claim that is honor and dignity in how much money you have. وكثرة الأولاد, how much family, children we have. فافتخروا بها. They have pride over it. وحسب بعضهم الشرف والعز في غصب أموال الناس. Some people thought that power and honor in taking, confiscating, to confiscate people money and to take people money by committing justice to them and by taking people life, by remaining in power, no matter what expense, you know, it was all means necessary, remaining in power, صفك دمائهم. واعتقد الطائف, I know if it left in man, some people say that how much money you spend, وصرف وتبذيره, then a person become famous, become known. Then I reflected, and Allah saying, does Allah care about all of that? He said, I found that what Allah says to be true against all of this claim. What Allah says, inna akramakum, and Allahi atqakum. The most honorable in the eyes of Allah is whom? Pious people. Allah doesn't care about money. Does Allah care about people, how much people money have? Allah give the money. Allah al-Ghani, Allah self-sufficient. Therefore, can you impress Allah with how much money you have? No. And who is more important, Allah or a human being? Creation of Allah, that they live and die. If He doesn't care, if Allah doesn't care about it, why should I care to try to impress some people but with it? Allah Almighty, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah huwa al-ghani. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله والله هو الغني. Oh humanity, you are indeed in need of Allah. Allah is all sufficient. يشاء يذهبكم. If you want to, he'll take you out. ويأتي بخلق جديد. And he replaces you with new people. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we're having us to believe sometimes our criterion of how, why we like this person or not, or how we become close to this person or not, based on the material world, is a wrong criterion. It's absolutely wrong. Because if this is not Allah's criterion, why it should be my criterion? If it's not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we differentiate between people, why should I differentiate people based on that? What color a person has, what money a person has, what currency they have, whether male or female. Because in the end of the day, Allah said that all of it doesn't matter. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهِ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. And human beings, they play in each other's psychology. And therefore, they realize that a person become impressed by particular things, then they impress them by that. And that's why one of the scholars was passing by, and he has his student with him. They passed by a big home that, you know, had a big gate. The man decorated the gate and made it so impressive. Beautiful gate. Therefore, the student started looking and said, wow, look at that. And the scholar said, turn away from it. He said, why? He said, he made it so that you say, wow, you should not say wow, and you should not look at it, because that's what he wants to have you to do, and they don't do it. You know what I mean? I said earlier, that doesn't mean a person cannot enjoy life. A Muslim can enjoy life, a nice car, a nice home, everything. But if a person pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have sajda to Allah, thank him for it, then he deserves it. Because a Muslim can have the best of the dunya and the best of the akhirah. There's no believing in Islam in order to have akhirah, you have to abandon the dunya. No one said that. But the gain of dunya has to be the gain of akhirah. But if the gain of dunya it become a loss of akhirah, it's not a gain. That's the criteria. The gain of dunya always has to be a gain in akhirah, otherwise is a lost. It will be in the record as a lost. And you don't want to do that. You know? Then he gave down now the fifth nasiha. قال إني رأيت الناس. Said, I have seen people. يَذُمُّ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا. Them in Arabic, the word them, is mean criticizing or mean putting people down. I saw people putting each other down. وَيَغْتَابُ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا. They backbite each other. فَوَجَدْتُ ذَلِكَ. I found this to be مِنَ الْحَسَدْ. Because of envies and jealousies. Filmal, because of wealth. People become envious and jealous because people have money. Waljah, people have prestige and power. Walilm, because people have knowledge. Therefore, a person become what? See a person has more money than them, they become jealous and envious. They see more person have more power or prestige than them, they become envious and jealous. They want to put them down. They see somebody have knowledge, they become envious and jealous. They wish that the person doesn't have that knowledge. Or they wish that person make a big mistake. Or that person embarrass themselves. فَتَأَمَّلْتُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. I reflected on what Allah said. قَوْلَهُ تَعَالَى. فَتَأَمَّلْتُ قَوْلَهُ تَعَالَى. نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِشَتْهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah said, I am the one who divided the ma'isha, the livelihood of people in dunya. Someone have more than the others with money, knowledge, you know, prestige, power. Allah said, فَعَلِمْتُ أَنَّ الْقِسْمَ. Then I come to know this division of wealth. كَانَتْ مِنَ اللَّهِ. It is from Allah. فِي الْأَزَلْ. Allah written this long time ago, that will be someone have more money than the others. فَمَا حَسَدْتُ أَحَدًا. When I come to know it's from Allah, Allah is the one who said, I am the one who divided the wealth. I give people children. I give people power. Then I've not become jealous because somebody have more children than me, or somebody have more money than me, or somebody have more knowledge. I will not become jealous, he said. فَمَا حَسَدْتُ أَحَدًا. I have no hasad. وَرَضِيتُ بِقِسْمَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. I accepted what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given. And here that I would like just to share with you some of the things that I researched in this regard. This is a very, very important nasiha that Imam Hatim al Asam have mentioned. And Imam Ibn Sirin, rahimahullah. You know Ibn Sirin? Do you know Ibn Sirin? The man who interpreted dreams. That all people know about him. But Ibn Sirin is muhaddith. Ibn Sirin is faqih. He's alim in many ways. But his book of dreams become more famous because he become more expert, have more expertise on dreams than other scholars, before he'd been known for that. But he has other quality. Look what he said. Ibn Sirin, rahimullah, said, ما حسدت أحدا على شيء من أمر الدنيا. He said, I never become jealous and envious or regarding anyone who have any materialistic gains of this dunya. Why? Why Ibn Sirin, rahimukallah? Why didn't you have that? He said, because لأنه إن كان من أهل الجنة. If a person I'm envious to, I'm jealous with, if he or she, a woman or a man of paradise, I said to myself, كيف أحسده? How come I will become jealous of him because of dunya? And he will get better than it in akhira. This is nothing for what he's gonna get, what she's gonna get. No, why am I jealous of them in dunya? If they are people of paradise. وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. Because either this or that. If a person to be from people of hellfire, فَكَيْفَ أَحْسُدُ عَلَى أَمْرَ الدُّنْيَا وَهُوَ يَسُورُ إِلَى النَّارِ. How can I become jealous of this person and his end result will be hellfire? Abode be hellfire. Why should I be jealous? It's temporary dunya. وَقَالَ الْحَسَنَ الْبَصْرِي. Imam al-Hasan al-Basri. You know al-Hasan al-Basri? Who's al-Hasan al-Basri? Maliha. You know al-Hasan al-Basri? You don't know al-Hasan al-Basri? If al-Hasan al-Basri, we live in today, will be in the headline news. No, I'm saying, if you live in today, or if the media, what his time? If you live in today, it might not be in the headline news. But if this media was in his time, they would be quoting al-Hasan al-Basri on the radio and TV and the internet and every place. Rahimahullah. Was a giant. Okay. Al-Hasan al-Basri from al-Tabi'een. قَالَ مَا رَأَيْتُ ظَالِمًا أَشْبَهْ بِمَظْلُومٍ مِنْ حَاسِدٍ. Sometimes some of the things are telling you that the beauty of it is in Arabic. I'm not saying this to feel bad because you don't know Arabic. قَالَ مَا رَأَيْتُ ظَالِمًا أَشْبَهْ بِمَظْلُومٍ مِنْ حَاسِدٍ. I have not seen someone who commit injustice look like somebody who been wronged. I have not seen anyone wrong people look like who been wronged himself more than the envious person or the person who's jealous person. طيب يا أخي, what happened? Why? يا ابن سيرين رحمك الله. قال, because a person is living, نفس دائم, وحزن لازم. He said a person is always sad. His envious wish ill for other people, but he wronged his own self. He became the victim himself, the victim of himself. حزن لازم. He's unhappy. He's always unhappy because other people have more than him or her. حزن لازم. وغم لا ينفد. What is that? Doesn't have an end. How comes he had that more? Gham, sadness, you know, unhappiness. There's endless of it. Every day is worse than the day before it. Because you come to know more people more than him. You become more hasad. And the people of hasad sometimes, like this category that Imam, Al-Hasan al-Basri described, rahimullah, they are the people who interest in people news. They say, how much money do you make? What do you do? How much money you make? How many days? And not because they want to make dua for you, they want to have hasad. Like, I come to know him make more money than me. Oh, subhanAllah, him, this, her. I don't believe that. Do you believe how much she makes? She makes more than me. She makes double than I make. So what? You're gonna die one day. So what if somebody make more than me? So what? Somebody will make $1 million a month. So what? Make $1 billion a month. So what? What is that all about? And become like so worried about it. قال أبو حاتم, another scholar says, الواجب على العاقل مجانبة الحسد. He said a wise person should stay away from envy and jealousy. على الأحوال كلها, in all conditions. Why? فإن هو الخصال. He says the least of jealousy is the following. One, ترك الرضا بالقضاء. ترك الرضا بالقضاء. A person become unhappy with Allah's decision. He said to Allah, oh Allah, you're making mistakes. You give money to the wrong people. Why you do that? You're wrong, saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah, can Allah be wrong? لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله.
This is the leaf?
Yeah. You know, those Muslim scholars, they are doctors. They analyze you so bad, you read, by the end of the night, you read in the book, he says, subhanAllah, let me look to myself in the mirror. What's wrong with me? What kind of disease do I have? رضا بالقضاء وإرادة ضد ما حكم الله لعباده. You want Allah to change His rule. He said, I want you to make different decision, Ya Allah. ثم انطواء الضمير على زوال النعم من المسلم. انطواء الضمير على زوال النعم من المسلم والحاسد لا تأذى روحه ولا يستريح بدنه. ثم انطواء الضمير. A person inside them, in their heart, they wanted the harm for others. They want the goodness of Allah give to other people to be taken away from them. Okay. والحاسد, a jealousy person, did not become rest. He become restless until he sees people in misery. Then he or she become happy. But if people are happy, he is not happy. إن تصيبكم حسنة إيش؟ القرآن says about the منافقين. إن تصيبكم حسنة, if something good happened to you, تسؤهم. وإن تصيبكم سيئة يفرحوا بها. If something bad happened to you, they become excited. They become happy. But something good happened to you, they become sad. How come? طيب. قال الإمام السمرقندي يحصل للحاسد خمس عقوبات. He said five punishment happen to the person who is envious. قبل أن يصل حسده للمحسود. Before his envious reach the person they've been envious against. What are the things? أولها غم لا ينقطع. What is that never end? Sadness, depressions, and so forth, never end. Because of that, that people are unhappy and happy with life, not because they have clinical issues and so forth. They're happy because emotionally they think always about other people don't have what the people that have, and they are unhappy that the people being having more prosperity. Therefore, they have this hasad. They cannot sleep well at night. They have nightmares. Second, مصيبة لا يؤجر عليها. This is very interesting. Those people are amazing people. مصيبة. You know what مصيبة is? What is مصيبة? Difficulty and calamity. If somebody losing sleep at night because his a sister have a hasad and against another sister or against his brother or brother having hasad, like, subhanAllah, she did this and like, I cannot sleep. I have heard people say to me, you know, when I heard this news, I couldn't sleep. As if bad news. It's good news about somebody else. Why you couldn't sleep? Hasad make them not be able to sleep. Jealousy. Envies. Therefore, he said, is musibah? Isn't that calamity a person couldn't sleep because someone has something good happened to them? It's musibah. But when a person is hurting, the person who's jealous, is it hurting or not? Is a hurting person? Been hurt emotionally. It's true or not? But that hurt will not get a reward for it. Be punished for it. Been punished twice. You hear what I'm saying? Musiba la yujar aliha. Self-inflicted what? Wound. That he will not get reward for it. ثالثا, number three, مذمة لا يحمد عليها. Is a character, is a deficiency that no one will praise him or have for it. Is a deficiency. Number four, سخط الرب. Allah will become displeased with that person. Number five, يقلق باب التوفيق. Will close the door of what? Tawfiq, success. He will not be a successful person. Will fail in life. طيب, ما هي أنواع الحسد? What are the type of jealousy? Different categories of it. أول ساتو ابن القيم, then I come to Imam al-Ghazali. Imam ibn al-Qayyim says, number one type of hasad, excuse me, hasad that you concealed. Jealousy and envy that you keep inside. It's in the heart, but you never verbalize it, you never said anything, you never did anything. يخفي الإنسان. But a person, لا يترتب عليه أذى. A person doesn't want that person to get hurt. But also, is a person doesn't want something bad to happen to that person. He's jealous, says, oh, I didn't get that grade. But he's not, he doesn't want the other person to have bad grade. And this, by the way, is most of people have that. Ibn al-Qayyim says, as long a person does not wish ill for the other person, is something that unavoidable, but it's better to leave, not to have that. But you should have that in deen, not in dunya. Somebody do tahajjud, and he come to know that he prayed tahajjud at night. He says, subhanAllah, he does tahajjud. How come I'm sleeping at night? Perhaps that may help you to pray tahajjud. But you don't want to say, oh, I wish you can, you know, sleep through the night, not pray Tahajjud anymore. You really happy for them, but you wish you, if you can do this the same. That's nothing wrong with that. Wishing having the same without having the other person, ni'mah, to be taken away from them. It's called ghibta, ghibta in Arabic. And also, a person have more knowledge than you, have more Quran than you. And he says, subhanAllah, I wish I have more Quran. But he never wished ill that person to forget the Quran or to make mistakes or something like that. That's positive. You know? Or you see somebody, Allah give them wealth, and they do a lot of charity with it. They give away. You wish you have the money to do the same, not to have the money for the money. Without wishing that person to lose their wealth. That's called ghibta. Okay? That is, ulama says, in deen, in matter like this, it's recommended for a person to say, if I do this, I will do that. Or if I have this, I will do that. Now, طيب. Which was called tamanni al-mithl. Hasad al-qibta also had second category in Imam Qayyim, that a person speak about it. All of this, remember, the first one is you conceal it. It's in the heart. You never verbalize it. But the other one, you come to someone says, I wish I'm like so-and-so, like Fulan. I wish like so-and-so in this and that. He says, in dunya, then when you verbalize it, it's not good. It dislikes in dunya. Why? Because your criterion of this person, in terms of materials, you like them and so forth, you made them as a model and example because of only dunya. But you don't realize maybe they have other issues in their life. But if it's a matter of deen, you verbalize it, you're encouraging people to say, subhanAllah, I come to know so-and-so, that's Qiyamul Layl. I wish all of us like him. That's good, because you're encouraging people.
Isn't it also true that when you ask for this in dunya, you know that Allah has already fixed your income or your dunya, and you're asking him to break that. But in the deen, Allah has not fixed it.
Yes.
Right? So you can get more. It's not something that is limited. You know, you can make more and more. Is that true?
Of course, Allah can give also dunya. Allah is a Razzaq.
Right. But he has already said that I have defined your provision. So when you ask...
But you don't know how he defined the provision. But you can ask Allah from risk. That somebody have risk?
Yeah.
More provision than you? You said, oh, Allah, give me the same. But those ulama of raqaiq said, don't even concern about that. Ask Allah to give you risk. Not like so-and-so, like so-and-so. Because he might give you like so-and-so and give you the whole package. And he might not like the package.
Risk is more than money.
Like you hear that? It comes with the package. You want that? وَمَنْ كَثِرَتْ نِعَمُهُ كَثِرَتْ نِقَمُ. That Ibn Ata' says. Ibn Ata' says, sometimes all the favor comes with the test. رحمه الله ابن عطاء السكندري قال من كثرت نعمه whoever the, Allah give them نعم the نعم comes with test no نعمة comes with no test but if you ask for it be ready for the test that comes with it وأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه Allah may test someone ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه he tests him but he tests him with wealth أكرمه هنا فيقول ربي أكرمن وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهانه. You can test him with no wealth and test him with wealth. Therefore, don't ask for the test if you cannot take it. Like the man who said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to become wealthy. Rasulullah said, you will not be able to handle it. They said, Ya Rasulullah, just ask Allah for me to have money and you see what I'm going to do with it. I'm going to do well. Rasulullah said, you personally, you're not going to be able to handle it. He said, Ya Allah, Ya Rasulullah, ask Allah. I just want money. Rasulullah made dua for him. The man had get the money. He used to be in the first line of the masjid. Becoming last line, disappeared, coming only Jum'ah. Now Jum'ah doesn't come. Because his wealth becomes so much, he has to move out of Medina. To move to the suburb because his business develops so much, he has to have more land. Then Rasulullah ﷺ asked for zakah. They sent him man to collect zakah. He gave Rasulullah ﷺ a sick animal for zakah. But Rasulullah ﷺ refused to take it. Then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq refused to take his zakah. Subhanallah. Because he made a promise to Allah and he broke it. When Allah gave him, bakhil, become stingy, as Allah says in the Quran. طيب. And then Ibn al-Qayyim said the last categories, tamanni zawal al-ni'am, a person wished ill for other people. He had three categories. But Imam al-Ghazali, rahmullah, had more than that. Look what al-Ghazali, rahmullah, says. Number one, an yuhib zawal al-ni'ma, hatta iza lam tantaqil ilayhi, wahada aswa. A person wish ill for people, like somebody, see somebody have wealth, he doesn't say, oh Allah, take the wealth from them and give it to me. So Allah, I don't want the wealth, but I want them to be poor. I just want them. What is this? Listen, sisters, brothers. Do you have people like that living this earth or no? You have seen people chatting on the internet wishing that? Yes. They wish ill for people. They want misery for everybody. طيب. اثنين. رغبته في زوال النعمة إليه لا زواله عنها. Okay. رغبته في النعمة إليه لا زواله عنها. The person, he won't have the same thing, but he doesn't want the other person to lose it. He said, I want to have the same. It's a level of jealousy. Okay. Number three. أن يتمنى عينها أن يتمنى عينها بل مثلها فإن عجز عن مثلها أحب زوالها. Listen. Somebody drive a car. And a person said, I want this man car. Not a car like it. I want this car. How are you going to get it? Either you steal it. You know what I mean? Or you wish that you buy it from him so that you drive it, that he doesn't have it anymore. Or you wish that he become in a financial situation where he come to you and give it to you almost free because you want money. Or, أَوْتَمَنِّي مِثْلَهَا. He says, not the same car, I want a car like it. But I want this person, when I have the car, I want this person not to have the same car. Because I cannot stand it to see someone driving the same car I'm driving. Well, I wish he lose his car, and I get a car like it, and he doesn't have that car anymore. It happened or not? Guys, like as we're talking about people in the moon, or the human being, could be next door, could be living in the same house. Am I correct? Well, Imam al-Ghazali correct, actually, not me, you know, claiming credit, yeah. أن يشتهي مثلها بغير زوالها فإن لم تحصل لا يحب زوالها. He said, a person, that's what Imam al-Qayyim said, a person want the same, but if he doesn't have it, he wish the other person good, that he doesn't want to the other person to lose. Those are the category Imam al-Ghazali said. طيب, how do you cure jealousy? علاج, what is the medicine? Let me go, before I speak to medicine here, because I'm going to talk to you about the psychological, emotional aspect of jealousy. Psychoanalysis. A person have envy and jealousy toward people that make them lose sleep at night, they have psychological problem. They have a psychological problem. They lack confidence. Listen to this carefully. They lack confidence. They have low self-esteem. They want to do more than they could. They want to chew more than they can have. They are misunderstanding the limitation, their limitation. They misunderstand the social laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that ni'am can stay in one place, but Allah take it to another. وَتَرِكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. It doesn't remain in one place. It doesn't understand that law. And a person also, he will lack of energy of producing. Because he or she, they always say they're not good enough. And their goal, their goal in life is always depends on the failure of others. Not on their own success. They depend on how many people are going to fail so as to succeed. Therefore, they don't work hard in the school to get A, but they want many people to have C, so because they don't want to study, so that they become equal. لَوْ تَكْفُرُونَ كَمَا كَفَرُوا فَتَكُنُونَ سَوَىٰ. Therefore, they don't have the energy to do the right thing, therefore they want to bring everything down with them. Now, assalamu alaikum, good to see you. One of the aspects of it, of jealousy, which is this, I'm sharing with what my father, rahmullah, was telling me. He said that, listen, I was a young man, and I get excited about something without telling you the whole story. But anyway, he said to me, the criterion of hasad, let me show it to you. He said, let me show you the criterion of hasad. I said, what is it? He said, if you heard something about your own brother or a family or a cousin of yours who did very well, that better than you in school, okay? Or in the summertime you go work and that person end of the day, because we try to make money, he make more money than you. Look, which is very, you know, very difficult criteria. When he told me that, I get worried. He said, if you feel sad that he made more money more than you, you are jealous. I said, but how are we going to control the emotions? He said, by making dua for him. If you feel sad, like, he made more money than me. You're not sad because you made less, you didn't make money, but the fact that somebody made more than you. That's your criteria. Hasad. He said, if he loses that person and you become happy because they lost, it's a sign of hasad, jealousy. If somebody told you, somebody else, so-and-so get divorced, and he said, I told you that marriage is not going to work. Subhanallah, why are you so happy that somebody got divorced? Why are you so happy that somebody failed that exam? Why are you so happy that person even have an accident? There's happiness in the heart for a harm happened to another Muslim, a sign of jealousy. Very bad. But listen to this carefully, and this is very scary. He said, if you are neutral, and you know the person is your cousin, is your brother, and you're neutral, you have a bordering hasad because you should have been happy for them. If you said, yeah. You know what I mean? That bordering hasad. Why did you become happy for them? You should want, not only that, you should congratulate them, you should feel excited for them. Now, what is the medicine? Medicine is the following. I elaborated on this nasiha because it's a very important topic. I didn't want to just pass it without elaborating on it. Number one, قطع النظر عن الناس وتعليق القلب بالله. قطع النظر عن الناس. Do not make your criterion in this dunya is excitement about people, human being, but make it about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I just want to tell you something that I saw very positive in meeting one of the wealthiest people living today. The sheikh was next to me, said to him, many people have wealth, but they don't do the right thing with it. I want to thank you for using your wealth, helping poor people and so forth. He said, I would not have made the wealth if those people would not have bought my product to begin with. It doesn't come poor from here. He said, people bought my product. Therefore, I'm doing the giving back to people, he said. He said, you don't have to thank me for it at all. And then he says, it's God Almighty who gave. And then without recognizing his gift, then he might take the gift. A person who's not Muslim, by the way, who said that. It's a Christian man. Isn't that interesting? We left the meeting, and the sheikh told me, he said that what this man have said, many wealthy Muslims would not have said. They don't even remember it, unfortunately. But there's so many Muslims, wealthy Muslims, who do the right thing with their wealth. It's come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they recognize that. For they do the sadaqah jariyah. He said, Imam al-Ghazali rahimahullah, and other Muslim scholars who I combined, by the way, I read many, you know, cure, including my Sheikh Imam al-Ghazali, and I come with this list for you. He says, do not dwell, this is a word, do not dwell on people's wealth. Do not dwell on it. Don't talk every day about rich and famous. Yeah, you know, we know what happened? He bought new house, he bought new car, he bought this, he bought this. You're only news about how much people make, other people made that. قطع النظر والتعلق بالله. Connect your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Number two, and to say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah, when you enter your own home, when you see your children, your grandchildren, and you like them, you see your spouse, say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. So Allah keep it for you. You enter somebody home, say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you more. Train yourself, they said, in saying, MashaAllah, when you see something good happen to people. Number three, compete in righteous good deeds. Compete with people. Make your criterion of munafaza, of competition, that you want to come Fajr before everyone else. That's fine, by the way. Not because you want to show off, because you want Allah to reward you. You want to be the best. You want to give sadaqah more than anyone else. Not because you want to show off, because you want Allah to give you more. Compete in for akhirah. And that's why ulama said that when people compete in akhirah terms or akhirah sense for akhirah, their dunya become good and the akhirah become good. At-tanafus ala al-akhirah yuslihu al-dunya wa yuslihu al-akhirah. Competing in akhirah issues, akhirah gain, life to come, it makes this life good and life to come good. Well, munafas ala al-dunya, competing only for materialistic gain, does that have akhirah in mind? يفسد الدنيا ويفسد الآخرة. Destroy the dunya and destroy the akhirah. Number four. Learn to love good for people. حب الخير للناس. Love to love good things for people. That say subhanallah, I want to help so and so to become better. I want to help so-and-so with their home. I want to help so-and-so with this. حب الخير للناس. I come to know a man that two of his neighbors, they said to him, oh, they would like the new paint of your home. I'm talking about when I was in Sudan. This man went and bought paint for both neighbors and said, I can do the same. And they took 2 days for each house to paint this front wall. So that Since they like it, he wants them to have it, so they become happy. People go extra miles. And that's why, Muhammad ibn al-Qadir, rahimahullah, Imam Muhammad ibn al-Qadir, said to Imam Malik, one of the best hasanah you do, you make another Muslim happy. It khalas surur fi nafs al-Muslim. Number five. Ad-du'a'u lil-mahsud. That's my father was telling me, rahimahullah. You see somebody, you become envious. Immediately, in next prayer, make dua for them. Say, subhanAllah, I feel that in my heart a little bit, yeah? Oh Allah, whatever this man has or this woman has, oh Allah, give them the more ni'am, oh Allah, protect them, make them use it for the right things, use it for the akhirah. And oh Allah, protect my heart from all this envious and jealousies. And I ask from your bounty, give me the best. In this life, the best of life to come. اللهم اغنينا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك ورضاك عن سخطك. Oh Allah, make me self-sufficient with halal. And not me have to haram. And make me happy with your ta'a obedience, not with your committing sin. Disobeying you. Therefore, making dua for a person. Number six. الرضا بقضاء الله. Accepting Allah's decree. الرضا بقضاء الله. Sometimes you might feel that you're more senior than someone, or older than someone. But this person become ahead of you. Why this jealousy? Allah the one who do the qisma. Allah does not look to age. Allah give. So somebody says, and by the way, one of the things of a scholarship, I was taught when I was started learning Islam. You know the first thing they teach you? Before any ijazah, you know what they do? The scholar says he will not open a book with you unless you finished the adab al-ilm, the etiquette of seeking knowledge. They give you this chapter, they teach you for 6 months the same bab. They said, you don't understand that? Then you can teach you knowledge. Because the idea is this, they want you to teach a student, to become a student, that understand that when you, one of your goal to have the people whom you teach become better than you. If you have jealous with your student, you get my point? I would like Shad Imam to teach a class better than my class. I'm serious though, on that, my heart. I want a way to teach a class better than my class. Why? Because part of the success of a teacher is to produce the teacher better than them. Only in prophethood that does not care. Look at this. You have Imam Malik, rahimahullah, the best scholars in Medina, produce Imam Shafi'i. Imam Malik was very happy for him. There's no jealousy. Imam Shafi'i said, Malik ustadi wa anhu akhadtu al-ilm wa huwa al-hujja bayni wa bayna Allah. Said Malik, rahimahullah, is my teacher. And from him I took my knowledge. And he's my evidence before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he disagreed with Malik on certain issues. Malik, rahimullah, didn't mind that. You know how Abu Hanifa became an imam? Abu Hanifa, rahimullah, his sheikh, there's death happened in his family. And he says to Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimullah, sit in my place, teach, until I come back. By the way, this o'clock is stopped.
Yes, sir. Huh? 1:55 right now.
Yeah, because I've been watching this, and I said, this is not moving.
As long as you keep teaching.
So, I don't know. Yeah, very deceiving. You need to do something. Battery? I will buy battery for you, inshallah.
Inshallah, we have downstairs.
May Allah bless you. Therefore, he came back and asked Imam Abu Hanif, what did he do? He said, the 40 questions was given to me. 40 mas'ala. He said, what are they? He told him the 40 things. He agreed in 30-something with him and disagreed with the others. The sheikh disagreed with the student. But he did not say you're wrong. He said, I could have done different things. You know what he told him? Now I give you permission to teach. He did very well. He didn't say, like, who are you? You remember that I was teaching you? Like, who are you? No. He's happy that he's the student become a sheikh himself. Don't have jealousy. That's how human advance. That's how you advance human cause. That's how you change society. When people, their heart is clean. Qalb salim. Do you know the name of the Sheikh of Abu Hanifa, rahimullah, that I'm talking about? Ja'far Siddiq. No. Ja'far Siddiq, one of the teachers. But the Sheikh that I'm talking about, you know his name? His name is Hamad. Hamad. Do you know how much Abu Hanifa loved this man? Who disagreed with him? And then? He named his son after him. The son of Abu Hanif is named Hamad. Rahimahullah. He named him after his sheikh. That's how the love used to be. Okay, now, number what?
Six.
Number seven.
Six.
Number six? I think number seven. Number seven. التفكر في نتائج الحسد وأضراره. A person should think about the consequences of envies and jealousies and the hurt and the harm that it brings to the person. Sleepless, you know, restless, unhappiness, all of this. By the way, think about this. Any negative feeling you have, when you think about it rationally, it reduced. Seriously. Say if you lost something and you're sad, which is human nature, you're sad. But if you contemplate, says, what did I lose? I lose my watch. Subhanallah. Can I buy another watch? Yes. It could have been worse, yes. It could have been in my faith. Alhamdulillah, it's not in my faith. Yes. Does Allah compensate for what I lost? Yes. Then a person's sadness will become what? Less. Does akhirah to come? Life to come? Rasulullah was sad for a whole year, loss of Khadija radiallahu anha. But there's a level of sadness, that's human nature. But to reduce the sadness, to think about what? But akhirah. Family reunion in paradise. And the same thing about negative behavior. If a person is jealous, so jealous, like have what's called aggression teeth, what's it called?
Grinding
teeth, whatever it is. There's some people that has at that extent. Then a person says, why am I doing this? Why am I making fool of myself? Allah gave this person can give me. Why am I really wanting bad things to happen to them? How that gonna help me? I'm having hazard at night, I couldn't sleep at night. This person is sleeping, snoring in their home, and I'm losing sleep at my home. Why? Am I crazy? Number eight. أن يحذر نفور الناس عنه. That eventually, a person who have jealousy is going to what? Will reveal it. No matter how much they kept it, they're going to reveal it. How are they going to reveal it? They start backbiting people, put people down, making fun of them, wish them ill. And people come to know about it and say, what? listen, be careful, this guy has it. He's a person that does not want any good for anyone. Therefore, nufur and nas, people dislike to associate themselves with them. Because Allah says in the Quran, بَدَدْ الْبَغْضَاءُ مِنْ أَفْوَاهِمْ وَمَا تَخْفِي صُدُورُهُمْ أَكْبَرُ. Said, the grudge came out of their mouth, but their heart concealed more of it. It's not all of it. Little of it that came out of their mouth. And akhiran, the last one, and then we end the class. أَنْ يَعْمَلْ بِنَقِيدِ الْحَسَدِ. To do the opposite of the jealousy. What do I mean by that? Of a person become jealous because someone's children are more successful, he will say what? I'm going to make dua for the children of this person. In my umrah or my hajj, I'm someone like that, I'm going to fight this hasad. I'm going to make dua. My aunt that or my cousin who get married before I did, or they get the job more than before I did, I'm going to make dua for them. You know what I mean? Before you do that, then you take care of the heart. But the most moving thing you can do of this issue of jealousy is to remind yourself every day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at your heart. And we don't want him to look to a heart that's full of jealousy. We want Allah Almighty to look to a clean heart. Because this heart is so open, it's not concealed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then when you want Allah to look at you, you want Allah to look at clean heart. And that's why one of the Sahaba, Rasulullah said, a man of paradise will come from this side. A man came, he filled with a beard dripped with water, sat down. Next day, Rasulullah said the same thing. Third day, Rasulullah said, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As says, I want to see what this man does. He's man of paradise. What the shortcut? Let go to his shortcut. What he wanted is, and he said, I want to spend the night with you. He said, welcome. He spent the night, three nights with him. The guy pray Isha, go to sleep, woke up just before Fajr, pray his witr and so forth. And that's it. Monday came, or Thursday came, and the man was not fasting. But the sahab was fasting. 3 days over, he said, listen, I don't have any problem with my family. I want to spend 3 nights to observe you, because Rasulullah said, you're a man of paradise. I don't see you praying more than me, or fasting more than me. What do you do? He said, whatever you see, that's what I do. But let me tell you one thing I do every night. I never want to sleep any night with any jealousy or envy or hatred or grudge toward any person. Can you do that, brothers and sisters? Inshallah. Can you do that? Inshallah. If you do this tonight, you're going to sleep very lightly. Oh, it'll be the best pillow that you put your head on. Because you're going to be softer, you're going to be more cozy, and the hair will be more clear. And when we look for Fajr, the heart will be saying, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah. Instead, like, he got the money, he got the this. And, what is that? You know? Let's do it. Let's do it. Therefore, this is the whole purpose of this class. Jazakum Allah khair. Subhanakallah wa hamdik. La ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wal 'asr innal insana lafi khusr. Lilladheena amanu wa 'amilus salihati wa sabaru al-haqqi wa sabaru as-sabr. Subhana rabbika bil 'izzati 'amma yasifun. Wa salamun 'alal mursalin. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaykum.
اللهم